8 ways to build good study habits. The key to becoming an effective student is learning how to study smarter, not harder. This becomes more and more true as you advance in your education. An hour or two of studying a day is usually sufficient to make it through high school with satisfactory grades, but when college arrives, there aren't enough hours in the day to get all your studying done if you don't know how to study smarter. When it comes to developing good study habits, there is a method to all the madness. The type of study habits that you've come to practice in high school may not work so well in college. However, you can certainly build on those practices to make your study habits more disciplined, because you'll need to. In college, you'll have more responsibility and you'll have more independence. For first-time college students, this could be a challenge to balance. If you want better grades, you need more effective study habits. The key to effective studying isn't cramming or studying longer, but studying smarter. You can begin studying smarter with these 8 proven and effective study habits. Before we continue, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and activate the notification bell to receive your daily dose of knowledge. Number 1, first, know your learning style. We all have our own natural tendency for retaining new information, and there are 4 main learning styles. Visual learners learn best by seeing. They respond well to diagrams, color coding, video, and patterns. Auditory learners learn best by listening. They respond well to audio cues like speech, music, rhymes, and other sounds. Reading, writing learners learn best by reading and writing the material they need to study. Kinesthetic learners retain information best by doing. They enjoy role-playing, building models, drawing diagrams, and making flashcards. They need to put concepts into practice in the real world. 2, try not to do so much studying at one time. If you try to do too much studying at one time, you'll tire out and your studying will not be very effective. Space the work out over shorter periods of time. Taking short breaks will restore your mental energy so you can use study techniques such as the Pomodoro technique. Number 3, plan specific times for studying. Study time is any time you're really doing something related to schoolwork. It could be completing assigned reading, working on a paper or project, or studying for a test. Schedule specific times throughout the week for your study time. 4, try to study at the same times each day. Studying at the same time each day establishes a routine that becomes a regular part of your life, just like sleeping and eating. When a scheduled study time comes up during the day, you'll be mentally prepared to begin studying. 5, study in a variety of environments. Experts used to preach studying in the same room every time so your brain could click into focus mode as soon as you sat down. But in recent years, an alternative view has gained a lot of support. Research actually shows you can focus better by regularly changing your study location. The theory is that studying material in a variety of places helps your brain build up different associations in relation to the material you study, leading to stronger memories and better recall. 6, use active memorization. Reading the same information over and over is actually one of the least effective ways to memorize. One effective strategy is to picture a definition of a concept in your head. Saying the word out loud is also helpful. Creating acronyms for a list of things is yet another useful strategy. For example, when memorizing states in Northern Europe, use the acronym ELL to help you remember that Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania are located next to one another. 7, review your schoolwork over the weekend. Yes, weekend should be fun time, but there's also time to do some review. This will help you get ready on Monday morning for when another school week begins. Number 8, eliminate potential distractions before your study session starts. Sure, working in a noisy coffee shop or productive library may help some people, but trying to watch a movie or carry on a conversation while studying is doubtful to help anyone. Before you start, eliminate anything that might cause your mind to wander. First, gather everything you need. Having to wander somewhere else to collect your notes or important textbooks is an easy way to get sidetracked. And if other people are in the house watching television or music, you might want to move to a spot where you can't hear. Hey, thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to stay informed about our upcoming videos, because more incredible content is on the way.